Hi, Mr. Pulley here with a quick look at some of the ways that I use Schoology in my Western Civilization classroom. I'm going to start off with, first of all, an overview of my courses and how I have things arranged, and talk about how I have things to make life a little easier for my students, a little more interesting. After I do that, I'm going to move on to a series of short videos that sort of highlight how you can add some of those things to your courses. We'll start with the course image and sort of how that works to make it a longer, more interesting image, and also how that is affected in the dashboard view. The video after that will be the one on course unit pages, how I use those in my courses. Then we'll do one on the course banner, and that was a little more complicated because I'm going to include how I do the hot linked icons in that as well. After that, we'll follow up with one on embedded Google Docs in my classroom, and finally, how I use completion rules to keep my students on track. So let's get started, first of all, with just a general overview of how I organize my courses in Schoology. So for me, the key for how I set up my courses is consistent organization. And my organization may not be the same as you, where you do yours, but consistency, I think, is a key thing for your students. Mine is arranged or organized by units. And so the first unit has to do with early humans and civilizations. And what you'll find is in this unit is the first thing you'll see is a course homepage, then a folder of unit assignments, unit materials, which is text chapters, study guides, and resources, and then Unit 1 videos. If you look at Unit 2 here, you'll see that same structure, consistency, even down to the colors of the folders that I use. Now, this unit homepage, if I clicked on that, what you would see is this comes up here, which is an interactive homepage, and I'll show you how to make these in a future video. These are actually then linked to those same things. You can see I've got text tooltips on here that tell you these go to the various items that are in there. And then I've got embedded in here a Google Doc, which I'll show you how to do that again in a future video. And then I have to throw a few things in there. And this is another version of the Google Doc. I've actually switched from this format to this scrolling format. And this is just one from the beginning of the year. And I decided I like the other one better. So I've switched to that version. Going back to the course itself, you'll see the Unit 1 assignments. What I've got in here is the reading assignments, and the reading assignments use completion rules on this folder to force students to watch the video. Then they have to watch the next video in order to open up the reading questions. And so I kind of force them to do things in the order that I want and make sure that they're watching the videos as well as answering the reading questions. There's also the study guide inside the assessment folder, assignment folder for the unit test, as well as the short answer questions, which there are several questions there, and one of which will be assigned to them to answer. Then the tests itself are in there. There's an A version, which is the objective part of the test, and then there's also the short answer part within there, and the same for the B set, which is the modified version of the test for my students that have IEPs. And then finally, there is also then the unit materials, which is text chapters. The unit plan is in there, but they can get that, as you saw, embedded on the page. Just trying to make things accessible to place students in lots of different places and lots of different ways. And finally, besides the text chapters and study guides and things, there's then the videos. And what I've got in this case is the crash course videos and the lecture videos. The crash course videos we usually watch in class. The lecture videos are usually ones that you saw in that assignment that they are forced to watch to open up additional things. So following down there, that I've also got the Western Civ text within this folder. This folder has versions both that link through my Google Drive as well as housed here in Schoology. And then I have Western Civ materials, which is the syllabus, the semester plans, and a curriculum map that we've developed for this course. Then I have some writing resources, MLA resources, to give students tips and ideas and make sure they're following MLA 8 correctly, as well as some short answer writing strategies for them. And then I have two crash course video folders, which are the ones we watch throughout the year, or most of the ones we watch throughout the year. Then I've got a natural reading thing in here, which is sort of, again, additional supplemental material. But then I've got, then you see the next units going on and going on and further. You could, if you wanted to, just unpublish folders to clean things up a little bit, or I just sort of rotate my folders around and leave them all in there all year long, and just make it paste for me by saying, you know, when those folders are enabled and when they're
or when the assignments rather are enabled and when they are not. So that's a quick view of my course. Again, key thing for me is consistency. You may have also noticed some of these visual elements, like the images on the folders, the course image, and this banner up at the top, along with these hyperlinked icons. I'll do short videos on all of those. Stay tuned for the next ones. Thanks for watching.